let me and my classmates make cartoons of her, post on Insta, and y'all need to work on punctuation for real. Hey guys, it's Sharon. Today, I am exposing the secrets you are keeping from your teachers, and it is this video in specific that makes me so grateful I am not in school anymore, and so grateful that I never ever wanted to become a teacher. To all my teachers out there, you're doing amazing, sweetie. I am so proud of you. Good for you that you can put up with kids doing stuff like this, because I have made this video before. There is a part one, maybe there's a part two. I'm not sure. Maybe this is part two. Who knows? I just know there are more types of videos like this on my channel, and all of them just leave me a little bit sad with humanity and students and a little bit worried and concerned. But what's new? There's a lot of that on this channel. But anyways, you guys know the drill, and if you don't, you're about to find out. I asked you, okay, hey, send me the secrets that you're keeping from your teachers. And I do this type of content a lot where I expose your secrets, your embarrassing stories, whatever. It's all anonymous, which makes it great, but also prone to be more scary and concerning and alarming. But anyways, if you do want to see more videos like this, give us a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below. I do have a whole playlist where it is just me spilling all that tea that you can definitely binge and go check out. And if you would like to be in my videos just like this one, make sure to follow my Instagram, my Twitter, my TikTok, all that stuff, because I will be posting when I'm making videos, when you can be in them, yada yada yada. And of course, if you want to see more, you should definitely subscribe for more. But enough about that. Go grab your snacks, go grab your tea, maybe go grab your teachers. If you're a teacher, maybe go grab your 2 weeks notice. Let's get into this. When I was in school, I slept with my teacher's son, and I so my thing is, if my teacher had a hot son, I don't think I would go anywhere near that hot son, because if it ends wrong, if I do something they don't like, my biggest concern is, oh my gosh, will their mother be petty and fail me? And I'm just saying, no D is worth the D in the class, if you get what I mean. That is always the number one thing I think about. I'm like, do I want to get involved? Are my grades worth the risk? And usually the answer is always nah. I have stalked my German teacher to the point where I know his family tree, and I know that he is politically very involved. I also found out where he lives and where he grew up. I also know his father's phone number and his phone number. I also know that I'm very creeped out right now. Imagine being this poor German teacher, not knowing that this whole child, this whole student of his, knows his entire life story and basically all his information. You guys, credit card information, you want to shop for us real quick? I'm kidding. Please don't do that. But anyways, I'm very concerned. And when you get older and when you grow up, you should be in the FBI. That's some criminal minds type of stuff right there. During distance learning, I returned all my assignments days after the due date, and I told all four teachers that I just had network problems at night. I think it passed. Oh, that is so smart. That would have been a great excuse for school, right? I don't think that's gonna cut it in college, because then your professor could be like, well, you should have gone to the library, you should have gone to Starbucks, you should have gone to McDonald's, you should have gone somewhere. So maybe it's a great hack for like middle school, high school. Keeping it in mind though. One of my college professors is a total perv and has harassed me and several other girls in our department. So a bunch of us went behind his back and started keeping track of everything he said and done and reported him. He has no idea that it was like 6 girls who reported him and has been trying to find out who did it. He's no longer allowed to text us individually, and he said he won't be teaching next semester. And that's what you get for being a creepy perv that won't take no for an answer, and you start hitting on your students. And that's on that. We love to see it. Do I feel bad for this man? No. I'm sorry that you lost your job, but maybe if you weren't such a creepy pervert making people feel uncomfortable, you wouldn't have lost your job in the first place. Thank you very much. I've been taking pictures of the notes and sending them to myself, and on test/quiz days, I look on my Apple Watch at the notes. That is so smart. It's stuff like this that makes me think, man, I wish I had all this access to all these cool tools when I was in school. If it was a math test and I had a calculator, I would put like a little slip inside the calculator like cover, and I would roll it down and look a little bit. But if I had an Apple Watch, wow. How convenient. But also, I just feel like there's gonna be a teacher out there that's like, okay guys, put away your phones, put away your Apple Watches. It's a great hack, but how long will this hack last? I'm doing online school and I haven't done any of my math tests this year. I'm paying my older brother to do it. I have no idea what we are learning, so I guess I will never know geometry. Okay, speaking of math, hear me out. Never once have I used geometry, algebra 2, trigonometry, calculus in my life. And granted, if you're gonna study engineering or accounting, whatever involves math, yeah, you'll need math. I studied communications. Do I need math? Absolutely not. So was I stressed and going through it in trig, geometry, algebra 2, whatever, for nothing? Basically, that stupid Pythagorean theorem still haunts my dreams. But whatever, it is what it is. I just feel like it's so easy to cheat now with online school. It's like, what you gonna do? Nothing. There's this really hot teacher that all the girls at my all-girls school crush on. I made a book with pictures of him, and the girls went and left it on his desk saying how much the girls liked him. He found it and is now dating one of the girls, all because of a book that no one knew I wrote. Okay, this took a turn I was not expecting. I thought the teacher was gonna find that book, be really creeped out, and then call this parent-teacher conference and be like, your kids are making me feel uncomfortable, they're sexualizing me, blah blah blah, this is not professional, I'm a grown adult and these are children. Instead, the grown adult goes and dates one of the children that is over sexualizing him in a book and obsessing over them and completely forgetting the fact that he's a teacher and that's a student, and this is illegal. And that's where I'm getting at. This is disgusting. This man needs to be put behind bars. Sweetheart, the secret here isn't, oh my god, no one knows I put them together, that relationship is because of me. What people don't know is that this teacher isn't in jail when he should be. That's the secret. The son of the teacher that hates me the most likes me, and we kissed under the staircase behind the books. This sounds like a very dangerous situation. Remember when, like, that first story, I was like, see, I would be scared to get involved with any one of my teacher's sons, right? So this person knows the teacher does not like them at all, and they're gonna get involved with their son. Oh no, baby. That teacher owns you now. That teacher will destroy you if they wanted to. Just remember that and proceed with caution. And remember, no D is worth the D on the report card. Okay, okay. I saw him cheating on his wife with my math teacher. My math teacher knows and gives me straight A's to keep quiet. Well, hold up. So two teachers, got it. They're both cheating, hooking up with each other behind one teacher's wife's back. And this person's only getting straight A's from one teacher. What about the other teacher? I'd be like, oh, you're both giving me straight A's. Or guess who's gonna find out? You know what I would do though? They're still being crappy, and I feel like the wife still deserves to know because she's getting cheated on by a crappy human being. I would be like, give me A's. And at the end of the semester, the end of the school year, whatever, after I got all my A's, I would still tell the wife, by the way, your man sucks, he's been hooking up with my math teacher over there, here's a ruler, do what you want with that information. You know, if you're gonna cheat and you're gonna be crappy, then like, it's not my fault if you get exposed, you know? I'm literally obsessed with her. She's about to turn 34 and I'm about to turn 15. Am I waiting until I'm 18 to see if I have a chance? Maybe. Oh, sweetheart. Oh no. One, that is your teacher. It is illegal. Granted, I'm glad they said I'm waiting until I'm 18 till I'm legal at least. Which, okay, we got 3 years left to see if you really are in love with your teacher, or if, hear me out, or if you just think you're in love with your teacher because you're forced to see them every single day. Like, when we think about our friends in school, were we actually friends with those people, or were we just friends because we were made to spend time with them every single day of our lives? Think about that. Is it really a crush, or is it just a forced crush? I went there. I found my teacher's whole lesson plan for the whole year on Quizlet and have studied the Quizlet instead of the actual lessons. Every time there was an assignment or a quiz or a study guide or whatever, finding a Quizlet with all the answers was the best thing that could ever happen. Automatic hard eyes. Just the people out there that are making these Quizlets and posting these Quizlets, I hope they know they're the backbone of society, and I hope they have a wonderful day today and every single day. Thank you. That I hate him so much, I put laxatives in his water and I put his nudes and porn on the school website and got him fired. A lot of the things that were just revealed to me were illegal, like revenge porn. That's very not okay and very illegal, and I just can't help but wonder, how the heck do you hack a school's website? Is it not that protected? Also, you're doing a great job hacking. I mean, you might be great in cybersecurity. That could be a really nice career move for you. Second of all, it's stuff like this that makes me feel really bad for teachers, and so grateful that I am not a teacher and did not want to become one, because you kids are ruthless. I want to know, why do you hate him so much to post his revenge porn and to put laxatives in his water? Laxatives make you poop, y'all, if you didn't know that. So they're making this man's butt blow up. What did he do? Because if he failed you, that's on you, sis. If you failed a math test, those were your answers, not his. I'm just saying. Anyways, this poor man's. I keep telling my teachers that my Wi-Fi keeps going out. In reality, I'm just laying in bed waiting for the time to pass. Seriously, though. What they gonna do? Pandemic schooling? Who's actually doing school? Who? My female teacher took my phone, so after school I looked in her drawer and I found her vibrator. I took it home and I tried it out. I decided to keep it. There are so many things wrong with this and so many disgusting things about this. So one, why is the teacher bringing a sex toy to school? That is so inappropriate and so messed up. And I'm just saying, if I were a teacher and I work at a place surrounded by children, never would I think about bringing a sex toy there, because I'm surrounded by kids. So that's very concerning that she has an inappropriate secret thing in her desk at school at her job. Girl, just wait till you get home. Oh my god. Anyways, the fact that this person stole it and then used it, here's the thing, a vibrator, that goes in your hoo-ha or on your hoo-ha, right? I just want you to know that thing you put on in your hoo-ha was also on in your teacher's hoo-ha. So think about that. Now y'all are sharing hoo-ha germs and stuff like that. That is gross. Oh gosh. You know what'd be even worse? They use it and then they return it. Oh god, I'm gonna throw up. I really hope you sanitize the life out of that. Disgusting. I was just walking into school, but I was about 1.5 hours early, and I walked past a teacher's class and I saw her taking pictures of herself, but she was taking her shirt and bra down to get pics of her boobs. Even worse, she saw me looking at her. Again, I feel like work, school especially, is not the time to be doing all these sexual inappropriate things, because does it not freak you out that you're in a classroom? That classroom is soon to be filled with children and you're over here taking pictures of your chesticles? Did I just say chesticles? Like, I tried thinking of a funny word for boobs, like hoo-ha for vagina, and the first thing I thought of was chesticles. I'm so sorry I said that. But anyways, homegirl was over here like, let me take out my boobies in front of these ABCs chart, whatever, probably not elementary school, but that's besides the point. And then let me look straight into my student's eyes that is watching me take these pictures of my boobies. Fired. So fired. I cheated on my boyfriend with my math teacher. Neither of them know. My math teacher didn't know I was in his class or that I had a boyfriend. We both swiped right on Tinder. I really hope this is not like a high school teacher. I hope this is a professor, but the fact that they said teacher freaks me out. This poor boyfriend, I mean, he's at least playing the game legally and he's getting hurt over this perv coming on this minor. Again, I say this every single time. This isn't Pretty Little Liars. Y'all are Aria and Ezra, and Ezra should have been in jail a long time ago. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. In the classroom, I make goat noises to make them think someone's phone is going off. Who has a ringtone of a goat? Okay. That me and my friends write fanfics about him and email them to him anonymously. I would be so creeped out if I was a teacher and getting anonymous fanfics emailed to me. I think I'd quit and move to Guatemala. Like, there's no other solution. Maybe change my identity while I'm at it too. Why do y'all do this? Why? Listen, I get one thing is writing fanfics about your teacher. Okay, whatever. Let it all out if you must. Sending it to that poor man's? Why? Why do you want to torture and scare him? Could you imagine this teacher does like a reverse email search or something and figures out who sent it? How embarrassing would that be? Think about that. The reason I am taking my purse to the bathroom is none of his freaking business, and that's on that. Obviously, if I'm taking a purse to the bathroom, everyone's gonna assume it's my period, right? Because that's just that unsaid rule or thing that everyone knows. If I'm taking something to the bathroom, it's because it has something in there that I need, and it's usually period products. But still, why you gotta ask me? I'm sorry you don't know what a period is. That's not my problem. That is none of your business, frankly, if I want to take my purse or not. But here's a life hack. If you are taking your purse to the bathroom and someone asks you, why are you taking your purse? You can tell them that's none of your business, or if you want to be a little bit nice about it, even though it's true it's none of their business, just be like, I don't feel comfortable leaving my belongings here. And if they ask, well, what are your belongings? Just be like, again, none of your business, or be like, my money, my phone, whatever. I don't feel comfortable leaving here. And there's your save. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give us a thumbs up. If you have a secret that you are keeping from a teacher that you would like to expose in the comments below, because I did not expose it, definitely feel free to. Like I mentioned, I do have more videos just like this one on my channel. I also have videos of secrets that you're keeping from your mom, your dad, your brothers, your ex, your siblings, your crushes, your best friends, all that good stuff. And I will definitely have a lot more coming out as well. Now, shout of the day goes to Safi on Instagram. Thank you so much. If you would like to be shout of the day, just follow me on my Instagram and stay active. And of course, like I mentioned, I do make a lot of these videos where I just reveal your secrets, your embarrassing stories, and all that tea. And I have a playlist on my channel, and I also have a whole playlist on my channel that is all about periods, where it's like period tips, tricks, hacks, embarrassing stories, all that stuff. So if you'd like to see more, you should definitely subscribe for more. And if there is a specific video of secrets that I'm keeping from someone that you would like to see that I haven't done before, or you want to see it again, also let me know, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!